Miss Zhang, in this episode, we have what to watch, huh?
You're speaking Chinglish.
Chinglish? I don't understand, lo.
Chinglish refers to Chinese English. It also refers to spoken or written English that is influenced by Chinese language.
I don't want to speak Chinglish. Miss Zhang, please help me, la.
Don't worry. Our actors and actresses will demonstrate common Chinglish. Then our net teacher, Mr. Jolie, will teach us proper English.
Hey, today is a sunny day.
Yeah.
My grandma says she will be very happy. Laugh die me.
What are you saying? Laugh die me?
Huh?
Okay, first of all, the phrase laugh die me, it's a very, very classic Chinglish phrase. Why do we call it Chinglish? Because every word for word is translated directly from Cantonese. And a lot of times in English, that doesn't work. So in the future, if you want to tell someone about a really, really funny situation that you laugh really hard, you can say, oh, I laugh so hard. Or if it's a situation where it just happened at that moment, you can say, that's so hilarious.
Hello, FunEnglish student. Welcome to the Booksharing section.
Let us introduce ourselves first. I'm Minnie from FunEnglish.
I'm Emily from FunEnglish.
I'm Jessica from FunEnglish.
Do you like reading books?
Yes, of course.
Why do you like reading books?
It is because reading can help us gain knowledge and wisdom. There is a saying, open a book is profitable.
There are so many advantages in reading books.
But I don't know which book is good for us.
Don't worry, our teacher will share a book with us. Today we have the pleasure to invite Mr. William Lee, our vice principal, to share his favorite book with us.
Which book will you share with us?
Okay, today I would like to share a very useful, interesting book with all Bulgarian. It is called The 7 Habits of Highly Effective Teens by Sean Covey.
Why do you introduce this book to us?
Well, I found that today's teenagers are busier and more stressed than ever before. Like with schoolwork, hours of homework, exercise, helping at home. What's more is some challenges like peer pressure, anxiety of future, and sometimes we have some mixed feeling like depression and jealousy of others' successes, and also lots of temptation like pornography. So it seems like they could hardly have time to breathe. So besides the support from teachers and family, I just wonder if we can find some way for our teenagers to have self-help, to help to boost their self-image, build friendships, to resist peer pressure, and also to improve communication and relationship with parents and more. So that's why I want to recommend this book to all students and also all Pukanian.
What kind of book it is?
The 7 Habits, not only a guidebook for teenagers to overcome the obstacles in their growth, with real life examples from teens around the world, but also a compass. Do you know a compass? Or we use compass when we hike. A compass to guide teenagers through the way to become a healthy, a confident adult.
Which part of this book is the most interesting?
Well, I would like to quote one sentence from this book. Is that small changes can make huge differences. It uses example, just like if we want to fly from, let's say, Hong Kong to Britain, but may only one degree south, we will end up in Saudi Arabia, but not Britain. But you know, there's a big difference between Saudi Arabia and Britain. What's the meaning behind? It means don't look down only small changes. Even we have some little changes, we can have big impact, big improvement in our life.
What can we learn from this book?
So what can we learn from this book? As I mentioned from this book, there are 7 habits, okay? So are you ready for all these 7 habits? Okay, so the first one is be proactive. Is something about can-do attitude. It means we should take control and be responsible of our own life, but not to blame the others. In simplest way to explain is, we should be responsible for our own happiness or unhappiness, not to blame others. The second one is begin with the end in mind. We should be clear about what we want, where we want to end up in our life. Just like example, if we play a puzzle, we should know what picture we really want to make. If we don't know what's the picture, it's really difficult to finish the puzzle. So that's the second one, begin with the end in mind. And the third one is put the first thing first. That means we have to help ourselves to prioritize our life, to manage our time well. We should focus on and complete the most important things in our lives. So do you remember these 3 habits? The first one is be proactive, the second one is begin with the end in mind, and the third one is put first thing first. All these 3 is about our own self. Now I'm going to introduce the 4th, 5th, and the 6th with you. So the 4th one is think win-win. So we try to create an atmosphere of win-win in every relationship. Family, school, friends. We try to achieve to have a mutually beneficial solution in our relationship. The 5th one is to seek first to understand, then to be understood. Do you know what's the meaning? We have to learn how to, the most important communication skills, that is active listening. We usually like talking, we like telling other people what we think, but it seems like it's very difficult for ourselves to be a good listener. But listening is very important in the relationship. So this is another habit. And the last 2nd is synergize. In the simplest way to understand is 1 + 1 equal or larger than 3, but not 2. That means synergy is achieved when 2 or more people work together to create something better than either you or you could alone. Through this habit, it doesn't matter to have your way or my way, but we try to figure out a better way together. So as I just mentioned, the 4th, 5th, 6th, that is think win-win, seek first to understand, then to be understood, and then synergize. And these 3 habits is something about our outer self. So how about the last one? The last one is sharpen the saw. Saw is the tool, okay? So what's the meaning of sharpen the saw? It means we have to keep our personal self sharp so that we can have a better deal with our life. It means we have to regularly renew and strengthen all these habits in our life. We can't just have one take habit. We have to keep renew and strengthen all these habits. So with all these 7 habits, we can be a very effective teenagers and will easy to become a healthy and confident adults in the future.
Thank you very much for your sharing.
Let's go. Make no excuses now. I'm talking here and now. I'm talking here and now. Let's go. Your time is running out. I'm talking here and now. I'm talking here and now.